This is spiritual crystal card reading for Capricorn for the month of November. So thank you very much for all the positive comments. It's very encouraging for me. Thank you. So let's see for the first, the general energy of the month. Let's see what it is bringing to you. So Capricorn, first general energy, Capricorn. Capricorn, this is a very intense start. That means big transformation. Can have to do with moving place, with moving somewhere, maybe job or. But this is the start. Let's begin. It's a transformation. Something is changing. Let's start with this. Then. A second card of general energy of the month, and we have Capricorn. Let's concentrate a little bit better. So Capricorn, general energy of the month. This is a snowflake obsidian. This comes on top of the Moldavite. That means actually that the Moldavite means it's a big transformation. You have to change something. You have to go into your fears. Something is bothering you. Something has happened in the last few weeks, few days. And it is really, and you can only go through this transformation if you are confronting your fears. If you are confronting your negative emotions, something is really holding you back. If snowflake obsidian comes, it means it's quite radical. It can be anger, it can be fear, but it's quite intense. So let's see how you can deal with this, what you can do about this. It's the first week of November. And this is your, this is Rhodochrosit. Rhodochrosit, what is this one? It's very beautiful, very tender stone. I don't know if you can see. And it has to do with childhood. It has to do with the child within us. It has to do with our connections with the child, with the childhood. It's this, and because you have here the snowflake obsidian, this can have to do with anger, fear from your childhood, and this is holding you back for the big changes to happen in your life. So let's go and see on the second week. So the first week, start to look a little bit in your childhood, start to dig a little bit around there and see which times of my childhood have produced me fear that I still have now, or anger that I'm still carrying with me. Let's go like this, slowly, slowly, the first week. Second week of November. This is deep insights. This is sodalite, the blue one. So that happens. What means? You go the first week and you make a kind of analyse, you make a kind of looking and finding what happened during my childhood that produces me emotions that I'm still carrying with me now. So then you go into the second week and you start to meditate on it. You start, if you have sodalite, use sodalite to meditate. It's really a big helper. So you have it in your head, you concentrate on the sodalite, let it become all you. You are sodalite, sodalite is you. And just go into the donacy, go into the vibration of the stone, of the energy of the stone. And vibrate together with the stone. That means that you are actually opening certain levels where in your subconscious there can be things you are still hidden that you are not able to see. And through the meditation with the sodalite, you can open certain doors that will allow you to go back into the past and to see what has to be transformed. Second week of November. Third week of November. What happens then if you do this by Sira, by road, if you do this by one by one? On the third week you have the tiger eye. The tiger eye is also the third eye. I also do it on the third chakra. It's relative. But this is actually allowing you to see that there are more as one road. There are more as one possibility. So maybe there is for you a change ahead. Okay? And because of your fears, because of your anger or whatever negative emotion that is holding you back, it doesn't allow you to see the opportunities that are given to you, the possibilities that you have for to do for the moment. Maybe there is a possibility for you to work with other people. Maybe there is a possibility for you for inner growth. Maybe there is somebody close to you who is able to give you really good advices, but because of this anger or this shyness or this being afraid, it doesn't allow you to ask this person for help. It may be very close to you. Maybe it's a parent. Maybe it's a friend. Have a look in your environment. Who is there? Third week. Fourth week of November. This is green tourmaline. Green tourmaline means that there are old thoughts. Old thoughts are holding you back. That means that you have to go and look deeper. We go a little bit more in details here. Because it's a very old thing that actually is knocking on the door and wants to be transformed. So it's not always easy to find this, because we have been layer by layer by layer from the years, we have been doing different things, and every time the door close. So to come to this old thing, what is from the childhood, what is really holding us back, needs a lot of little doors to be opened. That's why you need to meditate with sodalite. Use sodalite to meditate about this, and so slowly to open up. If it is very difficult, find help. Ask help from somebody that you know who can help you in that situation. Let's see. Oh, this falls on its own. Here we have the falcon eye. The falcon eye that is saying to you, look, it's not that big. It's much smaller. It is something that has been, through the years, has been becoming an immense proportion, right? It has become a very big proportion. And actually, the root, the essence of this proportion, of this thing that has become a block, is maybe only that small. But through the years, through the fears, it has become like something that seems almost like you cannot overcome it, because it's so it became so big. So if it is fear, go back, because you will see actually when you go back, you will see that it's not that intense. It's just through the years it has been building up. That's why I always say, when something happens, when something knocks on the door, when there is a trigger that shows you something, deal with it immediately. Because if you don't deal with it immediately, it becomes such a big thing that actually at the end it feels like we cannot overcome it, we cannot deal with it. Because we have been so many times ignoring it. And the truth has changed. The truth of it. So I can ask a few questions more, a little bit more information for you, how to work, how to deal with this. So what is something you need to know this month? It is your higher self, it's selenite. So get in contact with your higher self, get in contact with your true self. Find maybe help from somebody, soulmate. Maybe there is somebody that you know with whom you can talk about it. What else? What else is important for you to know? Transformation. It is the month of transformation, not only for you, but for a lot of people, it is going through big transformation. And it's again Mulder Weed and Herkimer Diamant. Herkimer Diamant is coming a lot of times this month. And it is, if you have the possibility, wear Herkimer Diamant, wear it. Because it's going to help you. It's going to help you to open the doors. The doors who are closed, that you maybe have difficulty to go back because it is from a childhood. So that you find the locks, let's say, that you can find the things to open. Otherwise, use EFT. EFT you can find easily into the internet. You can use just EFT. It's Emotional Freedom Technique. There is a free site. You can download free DVDs and not DVDs, yeah, free on YouTube. You can see how it works. There's a free manual about EFT. It's a very good tool for to go into fears, anger, all these kind of negative emotions. It is fruit tapping on certain places that you can go into your subconscious, that the subconscious is opening, and it's a very effective and fast method for to clean. So I would advise you this. Go and have a look if you see that this is relevant for you. And if you feel that there is something that is quite deep and it is not so easy to be acknowledged, go then and have a look for EFT or find an EFT practitioner close to you who can help you with freeing this emotion. Because this emotion is holding you back for the big transformation, what is Moldavid. And Moldavid means a higher, your higher self. Transform in this light being that you truly are. Be the star that you are. Be the universe that you are. And for the moment you have this cleaning to do. So find somebody to help you with this difficult. And, very important. Don't wear Moldavid together with Herkimer Diamantis, because this is too strong. This is going to confuse you. Because even Herkimer Diamant, when you wear it the first time, some people, not all, you can have some reactions, like it is coming out, things are coming up. So if you feel like things are coming up and you don't really like it, try to keep on wearing it. I would advise you this. And maybe you can take some rescue drops from Bach. Take some rescues, because this is really helping you, because it is like, it has to go. One way or the other, it has to go. And for that it has to go, you have to acknowledge it. So it has to come out. There's nothing you can do about it. So it has to come out so that you can deal with it, so that you can let it loose, that you can let it go, so that the higher transformation can happen. You can meditate with Moldavid. Meditate. But I would rather say, because it is such a old emotion from the past, I would really advise you to meditate with Sodali Buddha. It's a very cooling energy as well. So it will cool down any emotion, what has to do with fear, anger, aggression, whatever comes from the past, it will cool it down as well. It will help you to look at it, to work with it, without having this intensity of the emotion. Because blue is also cooling. And then see which roads are there for you, because there are a lot of opportunities. There are a lot of opportunities, but you have this old, it's a very old thing that you are carrying with you, and it's on the heart level, of course. It's the emotion. It's the heart level. So I'm going to ask one other one for the fourth month. For the fourth week, excuse me. The fourth week for you. It has direction. You have to direct. It's like, I think you feel more like this is space, this is grounding, but it also feels like for the moment you've lost a little bit your direction, I would say. You don't really know what to do, where to go. And the second card is smoke quartz. That means, again, Let it go through the earth, it's grounding, but it's the past again, and it can be with a sudden loss of something you lost quite directly. Maybe it was a death that came quite from one day to the other, you know, so suddenly it was gone, and this you never really overcame this. And this is why it is really haunting you, because this is haunting. This is not something that is a light emotion that is just a little cleaning to be done. This is something a little bit more deeper. That's why I mentioned EFT as somebody in your surrounding that can help you by this. Because it has to go. It has to go. But for the moment you don't really know how. So I'm gonna ask one more question. So, how can you deal the best with all this? What is the best? It is to acknowledge the sadness. It is epidolitis. It may be through a loss. You have a sadness that you never acknowledged, and that's why there is anger. There is anger about this loss, anger about this, that it has been taken from you. And you don't see the meaning of it. You don't get it. Why did this happen to me? So this produces anger of not agreeing with this loss from the past. And it is time. This is tourmaline, but the watermelon tourmaline. It's time to, again, to be the whole you. It's time to stop the suffering. You don't need it anymore. It's the past. It is something that happened in the past. It is something that you have to let go. It's something that you... It's let it go so that you can find your true self again. That you can find your power again. That you can find your direction again. It's very important. Don't carry it any longer with you. It's too old. You don't need it anymore. It's the past. And the past is holding you back for to live in the here and now. Because you can see on the cards, it's holding you back in your daily life. It is something that is actually disturbing you in your daily life. So see what it is. Work with it. Let it go. Find different healing tools. So, also with lepidolite, you can wear the lepidolite on the heart chakra. You can also put it in a glass of water, and you can make it in a little bottle and take it like the rescue drops. Take it on a regular basis, three drops every 2-3 hours, until you find that this is actually blocking. Is there something more that you need to know? Okay, go into the anger, in the nervosity, anger. This is chrysocolla. Go into the anger, confront it. This reading may be only for one of you. This reading may be for that a lot of you that you can find it out. But I really hope to whom it will be speaking, that you really will be working with this, because it's very important. It's really your time now. You have the possibility, because the energies are there now. It's not all the time that the time is right. Now the time is right for let it go. So use the time and do it. Do it and let it go, so that you can go on with your life, and that you can find back your balance, find back your true self, find back your full potence. If you have any questions, you can write me an email or so, and if I have time, as soon as I can, I will answer. But I would say, with a lot of love, go for it, go and don't look back, just go for it and clean it out, and not stop until it is cleaned, until you are rid of it, until you feel that you are one again. because otherwise it will be something you will be carrying for the rest always with you. So let it loose. Another possibility is green tourmaline. If you have green tourmaline, wear a green tourmaline. It can be that this is something that can carry a few months. So wear a green tourmaline for to soften it. To soften it so that it can open up, so that slowly you can let it go. So I wish you all the best, a lot of love, a lot of light, and don't forget you're not alone. We are all surrounded with light beings and they're all with you. So a lot of love and go for it. Bye.